find me stay there. I believe it was one night. But of this old neighbors, I call it not his due. For soon he lost his garden and meant to hold the plough. For Adam was a ploughman, and ploughing first begun. And the next that did succeed him was Cain, the eldest son. Some of that generation the colleagues still pursue. That bread may not be wanting, remains the painful plough. For Samson was the strongest man, and Solomon was wise. Alexander fought to conquer, was all his daily prize. King David, he was valiant, and many thousands slew. But none of these great heroes could live without the plough. Old Plowman says the gardener, don't count your trade with ours. As walking in the garden to view the early flowers, there's all the curious borders and pleasant walks to view. There is no such contentment promoted by the plough. Old gardener says the ploughman, a calling don't despise. A rich man for his living upon his trade he lives. Were it not for the ploughman, both rich and poor was true. For we are all depending upon the painful plough. Behold the wealthy merchant who sails on foreign seas to bring forth gold and treasure to those who live at ease. Who brings the fruit and spices, silks and dainties too. They are brought from the Indies by virtue of the plough. So come all you jolly ploughmen of courage stout and bold, who labor all the winter in snowy wind and cold, to clothe your fields in plenty, your pastures to renew, and crown them with contentment.